Hi, I'm Isaac. For so long, I struggled through life, grappling with my sexuality, grappling with so much pain and hurt that ultimately led to detrimental effects on my adult relationships. All throughout childhood as a queer son in a conservative family, throughout graduate school, throughout my time as an adjunct professor, and even while working in my private practice as a therapist, shame and the sneaky, unnoticed pinch of internalized homophobia stuck with me, affecting my sexual relationships, my familial relationships, but most importantly, my relationship with myself. Queer RelationTips is a show for people just like us.
I knew I was different in daycare. Whenever they would split us in, I actually got in trouble a lot by it. They would split us into boy and girl groups, and I never wanted to be with the boy groups. I didn't like the toys that they let us play with. I always wanted to play in the kitchen, and I just wasn't allowed to, and I would get upset. I wanted to play with Barbies, and I couldn't because I'd get upset. So I knew I was queer at a very young age.
We struggle with relationships. Struggle to understand how to have healthy sex lives. Struggle to stabilize anxiety and depression.
Asking for what I want has changed my life because it's like I am able to release all expectation of myself. I'm able to release all expectation of other people. I'm able to be more compassionate because I know that when people, like if I say, you know, for example, like I was out the other night and I met this really nice guy and I was like, hey, like, I'd like to take you home with me. He's like, that's not really my thing. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. No big deal. And then we still had a great time, made out a little bit, got his number, kind of thing. But it's just like, I didn't feel any kind of like, sure, he said no, but that doesn't mean like he's rejecting me. He's just rejecting a proposal of sexual intimacy. But that has nothing to do with my worth.
Queer RelationTips is a place where we can grow from one another's stories, hear from queer leaders about their struggles and questions, and it's a place to find answers. During our first episodes, we talk with Trey Pearson, a Christian rock singer who came out as gay amidst his bustling career and family life, and the ways he had to grapple with the trauma of growing up suppressing his sexuality. We also talk with Dr. Tina Sellers, a sex therapist and educator, to learn about developmental trauma and its effects on us as adults. Influencer Kevin Garcia and therapist Matthias Roberts give us a glimpse into their lives and how they deal with sexual shame. We also talk with a Denver-based drag queen who struggles with anxiety and depression. We continue on to listen to a sweet, sweet soul as they tell us about finding authenticity after tackling alcoholism and shame. I sit with all these people and walk with them through their struggles and their brilliant insights. Queer RelationTips is here to listen and help queer folks have the love lives and relationships we crave. Our first 8 episodes drop June 13th, and starting in July, we'll post a new episode bi-weekly. You can subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, and SoundCloud, with more sites coming soon. And if you like the show, give us a review and tell everybody you know. Share the love. Whether it's growing up with shame, wading through the complexities of sex, asking questions about gender identity, or the difficulties of maintaining a relationship with someone you love, this podcast is here for you.
Well, I think so often people find it really difficult to receive the love of somebody else. And so there's all this questioning when somebody else is offering it. There's defensiveness. They defend themselves against somebody else's. They don't trust. They don't trust what they're saying. They doubt what they're saying.
Queer RelationTips is produced by iAmClinic, a sex-positive LGBTQ+ affirming practice in Denver, Colorado.